Well, you scored as many points as Kyrie. How good does that feel tonight?
I mean, it feels good, you know, for shots to pretty much just fall whenever I get around the basket. Main thing was just, you know, whatever's in my hands, have patience and figure out ways to either score, help somebody else score.
I don't think that driving dunk was a shot falling. I think you more threw it.
Yeah. Yeah.
What does it feel like to get one of those?
I mean, it feels good, you know, just to be able to kind of get back to the physicality that I want to play at. You know, I feel like I haven't been doing that with these first span of games. You know, I feel like I've lacked in that area. So being able to do something like that, just, you know, rebound a lot better, something that I'm trying to hold myself accountable for just to help the team out.
What's the feeling like to finally snap this four-game lead that we can get on the
win? Yeah, it's like the world is off of our shoulders now, you know. Most of those games we got down to the last second. Of course, we didn't want to lose those games, but it's just, you know, stuff happens. We got to kind of like learn from it and just keep moving forward. That's the main thing. And that's kind of like what we did tonight. We came out. We was positive. Energy was good. When it came to frustrations, we fought through that as a team. And we found a way to get through obstacles together.
How big of a back-to-back is this tomorrow night facing OKC?
It's real big. OKC is rolling right now. You know, we got to come in with our head on our shoulders. Then we got to know that they ain't going to come out and give us an easy game. You know, so.
The offense played a little bit more through you in the post, you know, in this game. Just what are your thoughts on how you handle those possessions and how important is it to, you know, be able to capitalize on those?
I just feel like I can build on it, you know, just really just having patience. You know, I appreciate them for having the faith in me and putting me in that position. And I feel like I actually, you know, got the job done in that area, you know, so pretty much it.
Daniel, going into halftime, the game was within single digits. It was pretty close. Mm-hmm. Was there anything that was said by one of you guys or the coaching staff that kind of got y'all's energy rolling there in the third quarter to take the game away?
Pretty much just make them drive and keep them off the three. That was the main thing that we had to take away and keep them from getting second chance points, keep them off the glass. So that kind of gave energy to us because it fueled the offense coming out.
Did it feel like the energy was better there at the start of the third than the beginning of the game?
Yeah, of course. You know, so pretty much.
Najee was pretty aggressive attacking the paint throughout the game. Just how helpful is it to have someone on the wing that's applying that much pressure, you know, in the paint?
It's great because just like I say with Clay, Luka, Kyrie, he's one of those guys that have some type of gravity pull towards him. So whenever it's him driving to the basket, it makes the job easier for guys on the back end because he finds them.
What was different in the third quarter for you guys as compared to the first half?
We made shots and played defense.
It's pretty good things to do.
It's basketball.
Yeah. Season high 22 points off the bench for Gafford. That's the most for any bench player this season for you guys. Just what kind of intensity did he bring to the game tonight?
Yeah, I thought he was great on both ends, defense and offense. His ability to change shots, rebound the ball, and then offensively we played through him in the post and he delivered. And so I thought he was really, really good. I thought his energy too, you know, was high for us the whole game. And so, again, we need that, especially coming off the bench.
Do you see a difference in how he kind of approaches the game when he's coming off the bench versus when he started, or how he's able to take advantage of matchups?
I think he's in the post when we started to play through him, I think he took advantage of that at a high level, but I think also giving us second opportunities. And then on the defensive end, his ability just to play the pick and roll and not give up the lob, I thought he was really good. And then one shot, I thought, again, San Antonio didn't shoot the ball well tonight. And that's, you know, when teams don't shoot the ball well, it means there's opportunity for rebounding. I thought we did a really good job rebounding the ball.
What are your thoughts on what you got on Jaden Hardy tonight?
Yeah, he was great. He was great on that road trip. And, again, he had carryover from that road trip tonight, and he was good setting, you know, getting us organized offensively and then defensively. He was competing.
Coach Kidd, you've now seen Gafford and Lively both start some games. What have you thought of each of their performances recently, and what goes into this decision of which one of those bigs you start?
Yeah, they both have played well as starters. I play well off the bench, and so we'll see how D-Live handles these next couple games as a starter, and we'll figure out who's going to start after that. But D-Live has been great. Gaff has been great. They both have sacrificed. They both can start. If it was the 80s, we would both play them at the same times, but unfortunately it's not the 80s, so only one can play, and right now D-Live is the starter.
Was PJ's minute cap 20?
It was... 19.
Well, you nailed it. Does it change?
I know.
Do you know if it changes going into tomorrow, or is that too quick of a turnaround?
I got in here too fast to get all the information from everybody else, so we'll see tomorrow how he feels, and we'll see if he's able to go tomorrow. We were just happy to get him back on the floor, and I thought his minutes were good, both on both ends.
What were your thoughts on the new jerseys?
I don't know. I don't know what our color schemes are. I thought we were San Antonio for a minute with the gray. I didn't see any blue or any green in there. So, but it's the city uniform edition, right? So it's got to mean something for Dallas to be gray. But I gotta get the information on the jersey of why it's gray. I'm not involved in that. But they do look cool. They're cool.
What did you see from Maxi starting at the four spot the last couple games?
Maxi has been great, starting at the four. Just the rebound and the energy. He's taking shots when he's open. But he's been great playing that starting role for us. Also coming off an injury and coming back. And so his role will change as we get healthy here and we get some guys off of restriction, off of minute restrictions. But I think when you look at the four, we're doing the same thing at the center position with the fours. We're letting the guys go for 3 or 4 minutes and then taking them out. And so until we can get past the restrictions, that's just the way it's going to have to be right now. And it's going to probably be choppy where offensively we will struggle some and defensively we'll struggle just because of the short amount of time guys are having.
Go ahead with questions for
you guys. What were you guys able to do in that third quarter when you outscored them by 20?
I think just play our game, defend, block out, get rebounds, and just with the pace.
What were your impression of what you got from Gafford tonight?
Yeah, great. I think he barely missed. I don't think he missed. But he was everywhere on the court, offense, defense, on the glass. So that's what we need for him every game.
You said throughout the streak that a big part of it was because of the inability to rebound. Tonight, tie the season high with 53 rebounds. Just how important is that aspect of the game for this team?
Yeah, very important. We talk about before the game, there's a lot of guys that crash on the Spurs, so we have to be extra careful. With the rebounds, and everybody just boxing out their own guy, get the rebound and just go.
Luka, I know what you usually say to this, but how physically right do you feel right now? Is it 100%? Is it something just a little bit less?
A little bit less.
Yeah.
You know.
Did you know how long it might take until you feel better? Is it a matter of time?
It's probably a matter of time. Just there's not a lot of time to rest, but I'll get better for sure. I promise.
Luka, back to back going into OKC. What's the mindset?
Play our game. That's it. They're a very tough team to beat. Just play our game.
Luka, I wanted to ask you a question about Real Madrid. Your last post on Twitter is Hala Madrid, and I wanted to ask you what Real Madrid means to you. How much of a fan are you? How much do you follow them now this season?
Following them every time. It's basketball, obviously, and it's football. I grew up there. He taught me everything. So it's a part of my life. You can call it second, third home, whatever you can call it. But I learned a lot of stuff there. And especially it gave me a way to be here right now. So I always appreciate that 100%.
Do you have any thoughts on how their season is going and how Mbappe is getting integrated into that team?
Oh yeah, obviously it could be better, but when you get a guy like him, it takes time to get used to it, but we'll figure out.
Look at tonight's game in the first quarter. It was your first two-steal first quarter of the year. After the miscommunication at the end of last game, was starting defensively strong something that you were emphasizing going into tonight?
Yeah, obviously. It should be like this every game. I think our third quarter was our best defensive quarter this game, but that wasn't me that last game, so just trying to make it right.